Welcome to the Tapes Archive's second episode of our new series simply called Music History. We take articles from the archives and bring them back to life with archival video, music, and photos. Everything you see and hear happened over two decades ago. Episode 2 is from an article featuring Mike D of the Beastie Boys, published back in 1992. At the time of the interview, D was promoting the Beastie Boys' new album, Check Your Head, and their concert at the Indiana State Fairgrounds. Let's get right to it and open the vault.
I'm from the Big Apple. Let's welcome a sensational rap crew as they join us to do their latest single on the Capitol label. The song is entitled Shadrach, and they are the Beastie Boys.
Beastie Boys' Mike D remembers the first time he heard rap blasting through a boombox on the streets of New York City. It was approximately 1980. The tapes were crude recordings known as battle tapes, overrun with loud scratching and performers rapping through distorted microphones. The music barely had a name. It was that new, and certainly no rappers had record contracts. And D, then a 14-year-old white, upper-middle-class New Yorker, had been existing on a steady musical diet of punk and reggae.
It's just like a sonic assault, like the same way probably when you first heard the Ramones, distorted, loud message.
1, 2, 3, 4!
Definitely special music that's held up on its own. But at the same time, part of the appeal was a completely new form of music that I knew was going to be too radical and too different for any of the kids who were in high school who were listening to punk notes.
Now, a dozen years later, he and the Beastie Boys, who will perform Saturday night at the State Fairgrounds to a sold-out audience, are continuing the tradition of loud, radical rap. And in the genre where the shelf life of groups is about equal to that of fresh meat, the Beastie Boys have thrived. On their new record, Check Your Head, the Beasties have continued to evolve, meshing rap, punk, live instruments, and musical samples into a dissonant but ultimately accessible mix. Little on the current Beastie Boys record would be mistaken for the group's biggest hit.
You gotta fight for your right to party!
D says he and partners King Ad Rock, Adam Horowitz, and MCA, Adam Yauch, like the idea of changing the group's sound.
Any groups that stay around that lasting power comes from really just doing what you want to do and not getting mixed up with too many forces outside of a group that will tell you to do a million different things in order to sell records. A lot of the problem, especially with rappers, is that you make a record that's successful and then all of a sudden you've got a manager and a business manager and a lawyer and a record label telling you, okay, repeat that success, make that same thing again. People don't want that same thing again. People want to hear something new. They want to hear innovation. They want, especially with rap.
D makes a strong case for rap and the role of three white Jewish men in it. He says License to Ill, the Beastie Boys' multi-platinum selling disc, exposed a largely white audience to rap, encouraging them to check out black rappers such as Public Enemy and Ice Cube.
Yeah, boy.
The best in men's clothing. Call Paul's Boutique at Janice. The number is 718-498-1043. That's Paul's Boutique, and they're in Brooklyn.
Because they grew up in an urban environment and have listened to rap for roughly half their lives, the Beastie Boys say the music is as natural for them as it is for anyone with a similar background.
There's a form of communication. Rap is an accessible medium and a genuinely new medium. Not like a kind of music where you have to study for 20 years to express somebody else's music. You're just saying what you feel. It's very similar to punk rock. So as opposed to like being kind of stale form of communication where someone's playing a rock and roll riff you've heard 1,000 times, singing about how a girl left them for the 8,000th time, you're hearing more music that, at least to me, especially growing up in Manhattan, like rap always represented. One of the main things with hip-hop and rap music is innovation was always integral to it. You know, the records that would come out that would change everything sonically, or you know, a guy that would come out that would drop a completely new lyrical style. Those would be the records that would get the most respect.
Mm-hmm.